Tap into a whole new world of financial possibilities. Genie, get it to get it.
Hello and welcome. It's big match cricket time. I know the COVID-19 has been a great dampener of inter-schools cricket. The historic and the traditional big match between Royal and St. Thomas's, the 142nd Roytho, will be played at the Singley Sports Club ground on the 28th, 29th and 30th of October. Yes, the Maitland Place ground will be such a different place this time around without the spectators. But make no mistake, the two schools have gone through a lot of preparations together with the Joint Match Organizing Committee and so many other stakeholders to make sure that it's a safe encounter over 3 days. And to talk about all that on Papa.com, who will be covering the game live over the 3 days together with Dialogue Television, have invited two former captains. One is Tevidu Senaratna of Royal College and the other is Dellon Pieris of St. Thomas's College. Gentlemen, welcome. And it's big match time. Why not?
Yes.
Yeah, it's nice to be around here back again.
I know. Tevidu, you're comfortable? How?
Yes, Sarit, I'm
being looking forward to the big game, I suppose.
Yeah, obviously. All the players are doing good. We are also hoping to see a good match.
Yes, just going back into the situation, it's so much of tradition and so much of preparations normally. But this time around, it has been a special case where everything is happening. I will first start with Dellon. How have been the preparation as far as St. Thomas's are concerned?
Yes, I think as we all know, it's a very challenging period during this COVID situation. But then again, school has made priorities towards making sure that we are able to carry on with cricket. And I think the team started their practices in about January. And they were preparing to play around in May, June initially, but then again, practices had to be called off again as a few players got infected with COVID and had to be quarantined. And but then again, now they're back in track and I think preparing really well in a new situation, like a new environment, bubble process, a lot of PCR has been done and being vaccinated. So I think it's a new challenge and a new environment to all the boys.
Yes, Dellon, just the same way, because of the unique situation of this big match, I know a lot of people would not only envy the opportunity given to the players, it's also keeping up the tradition of having the match being played over the years without a break, the oldest schools cricket encounter in the country and the second oldest schools cricket encounter in the world. Tevidu, I'm sure Royal, which has such a big history and a checkered one at that, have also done the same thing building up to this match?
Yeah, obviously, yeah. So, last year's big match was played, all 3 days were played, and unfortunately, one day wasn't played because of COVID. So, after that, both schools and all the organizing committees have been working hard to do to have the big match this year also. So, yeah, we have hoping to see a good match the coming days.
Yeah, I mean, there are some senior players in both teams and we've got youth international players on both sides. Two of them for Royal, Ahan and Sadisha, then Yasiru and Ryan for St. Thomas's. I mean, they can influence a lot. Not only they are key players for the respective teams, they are in a situation where they can impact on the team. Dellon, how do you see the senior players showing the way to a few first-timers in this team?
Yeah, I think Tomians are having only four colorsmen. And Shalin Dimel, I think, has been one of the most experienced campaigners in the Tomian lineup, having played three big matches and having like have performed really well at the big match. And I think his leadership and how he manages himself at the big game will influence the youngsters to be motivated and to perform well. As you said, having two national caps, Ryan Fernando and Yasir Rodrigo, will be a confidence booster for the team to know that they are leading the way and the youngsters have to play around them. And I think the seniors will be the key factor going on to the 3 days of the game.
Thevindu, Royal also have some really good performers who have done very well. Maybe not everybody knows what has been the preparation. What is the knowledge you have about these seniors and the juniors making their plans to make the game a success?
Yeah, so we have 5 colorsmen this year and one player who played last year, Aziz Manchanayake. So experience kept like Ahan Vikramasinghe, Isivara, Ishan Balasudhi, Kavindu Pathiratna. They have been playing for school for quite a long period, like 2 years or 3 years. So their experience will be a good chance for us. And as the freshers, from the freshers, there are 6 who have played the big match. The other 5 have to be competing with them also. So yeah, I think they have done a good job decision and
The schools authorities, the joint big match organizing committee, the health authorities, the parents in particular, sponsors, hoping this 142nd Roytho will be a great success. The big media hype, as we all know, will be a great situation. There are some impact players for this encounter. Thevindu, I will start with you. Whom do you think could probably play a key role and make a big mark in this 3-day encounter for Royal?
Yeah, so Ahan Vikramasinghe and Sadish, they are the 2 U19 caps, and I think they will play a big role in this game. And the experienced fast bowler Kavindu Pathiratna, he will be the key bowler for the for the match. And so I think the key players will be Ahan, Abdisha, Kavindu Pathiratna and Gishan Balasurya for this match.
What about St. Thomas's Delan? Whom do you think would be, you know, I mean, there are some good players. In your mind, who could make the biggest?
Yeah, I think Charlene Dimmel has to lead from the front, like step up his game, because he's having one of the youngest sides that St. Thomas has produced after about 20 years or so. So I think he'll have to lead the way from the front. And then Charlene Dimmel with Ryan Fernando, Yasir Rodrigo and Keniston will have to back him up. And I'm really looking forward to the youngsters like Rajin Tilakaratna, who's having about 5 more years to go in his school career. So I'm really looking forward to him and Romesh Mendis to be the game changers who will not expect them to be.
I will probably ask you a question about the team balance. How do you see the balance being maintained by the captain and especially the coach? Having a good team balance going into a 3-day encounter is very important.
Yeah, definitely the team balance has to be very important when it comes to a 3-day game. So I think the Thomians have made the best choice with having youngsters around the team to make sure that it's a long-term plan, and also they have done with the opportunities well, like the opportunities they were given, they have done really well. So I think the balance has been with having 5 to 6 batsmen, and then Rajin Tilakaratna to bowl the leg spinners, and Anup Palivadna as the off spinner, and having Caldera as the third seamer. So I think Tomins are having a good balance with 5 to 6 batsmen and 2 all-rounders in the middle and a couple of spinners.
Oh, that was a nice assumption. Nathan Caldera also mentioned. Devindu, you can also go to that same aspect about the balance of the Royal team. Sure, they are looking forward to making a huge impact, not only for themselves, but for the team, and make this big match a really tough one for the Tomians. How is the balance for Royal?
Yeah, so we haven't named the team yet, playing 11 yet. But as I think, three pacemen and about 5 to 6 batsmen have to be in the squad in 11. So, as we know, Isivara, Ahan, Pakhamdi Patriratna, Gishan Balasurya, left arm orthodox, and there are about three paces and 2 left arm orthodox. As for the probable 11, I sum. So, yeah. I think there'll be when the coach and the coaching staff and the school will get together and put a balanced 11, and we'll hope to give a tough game to St. Thomas.
That's what it's all about, tough game. Coach Dinesh Kumarasinghe, very experienced and always very helpful. Dylan, what do you think? Who will win the toss and what he would do?
I would say Tomians need to be positive and try and take it on to the Royalist. I would prefer if the Tomian side win the toss and bat first and put a good total on the board and then put pressure on the Royalist afterwards.
Devindu, what would be the situation? You all have a very well balanced side. What is your hint about the toss and what the captain would do? I'm sure Jehan Mubarak has special plans.
Yeah, Jehan Mubarak, Mr. Jehan Mubarak comes with like full of experience and full of surprises also. So I think if we win the toss, we should bowl first and keep it to a low score and hit a big target and give the Tomians again bat.
Okay, Dylan, it looks like to be a tremendous encounter, so much of hope. What's your message to the playing team?
So to Shalin and the Tomian team, first of all, I would like to wish them all the very best for the upcoming 3 days. And as a past captain, I would say go out there, enjoy, give out your hearts out and play hard. And also make sure that you cherish the memories that you have with our rivals. Because those are the bonds that will lead a long way. And just on a note, I think the shield is where it belongs and hope it stays home.
Okay, what happens? Ropes is not only the big match. There is so much happening outside the ropes too. Thevindu, your message to the young who are looking forward to 3 days of solid cricket.
Yeah, first of all, I would like to wish the best of luck to Ahan Wickremesinghe and the playing 11 and all, and the coaching staff as well. And as Dylan said, the shield is with them. Yeah, but as in a joint dinner once Kavindu Madarasinghe, past captain, said, keep the shield modified and it will be coming to our Reed Avenue again. So, hope to see a good match. Enjoy, boys, and give you the best. That's all.
Okay, that was nice. On behalf of thepapare.com, we would like to thank the two former captains, Dylan Pieris of St. Thomas's and Thevindu Senaratna of Royal, for joining us on our invitation. Yes, this is a huge game. I know it is without spectators, but make no mistake, the whole world, as far as Sri Lanka's cricket is concerned, will be with the papare.com and Dialogue Television over the 3 days starting from 28th. We certainly hope that it will be an eventful game, not troubled by the weather. There are a few indications that the weather may probably intervene, because there's been so much happening to make this event a success. So thank you very much, boys, for joining us. And we wish the players all the best. And thank you very much for being with the Royal Thomian. Well, this has been a tremendous encounter. It is going to be on paper, going to be on the field. No questions about it. Everybody who loves cricket, everybody who loves school cricket, everybody who loves Royal, everybody who loves St. Thomas's will be logged on, will be looking to see how the boys will perform over the 3 days starting on the 28th. It'll be a great game. We wish it to be such a good one, not hampered by the weather, and certainly everybody to enjoy. Thank you very much for being with us.
Stay on the ball with the Papare Sports News Alerts. Don't miss out on what's happening in the world of sport. Type sports and send to 678 to register. 30 rupees per month. Conditions apply.